Now here also in this limit n tends to infinity, we have n raised to the power k and sine n factorial square and divide by n plus 2, where k lies between 0 to 1. Now this is very, very important because it is given this, the range is very, very important that it is k is lying between 0 to 1. Now since k is lying between 0 to 1, we'll try to take advantage of that and we'll try to arrange this equation or arrange this limit in such a way that we can easily find out the limits, right? So the first thing that should strike you here in this type of question is you can divide here by n raised to the power k, right? So if you do so, you will be able to have in the numerator, we will be having sine n factorial, right, square, and this divided by, so since you have divided this by n raised to the power k, so finally we can say we are having here n divided by n raised to the power k plus 2 divided by n raised to the power k, right? This is the basic understanding that you need to have for the limits. Now, just try to understand one very basic and simple thing. Since here we have k is between 0 to 1, so this quantity, if we write down this again, so this is sine square n factorial divided by n raised to the power 1 minus k and 1 plus 2 by n, right? And of course, we have the limit n tends to infinity. Now here we have n tends to infinity, and now you try to see that here you have some finite quantity. And why this is finite? Because we know that the value of sine x will always lie between 0 to 1, right? This will always lie between 0 to 1. So this is some finite, or maybe not 0 to 1, minus 1 to 1, right? Since this is a square, so we can say this is square will lie between sine square x will always lie between 0 to 1, right? Both can be included. Here we have some finite quantity. And if you try to observe where n tends to infinity, this will be 0, right? And this will be turning out some infinity. So basically we have some finite quantity divided by some infinite quantity, right? And this is not indeterminate form. We know that. This is nothing but equal to 0, fine? So this is how we can say that this is the correct answer. Now, we have taken use of this, that is k is lying between 0 to 1, right? Otherwise, the thing would have been different. So the conditions that are mentioned over here are very, very important. So here, if we try to, let us take one more question. Now, this is a very interesting question here. That is, f of x is given to us as x minus 2 by 2, right? Then, so yes, I'll come to you. It is saying that in 0 to pi, which is included, which of the following options are correct? So first of all, we have to understand about tan of fx, right? When tan is continuous or when tan is not continuous. So yahan pe if we try to take a very basic idea, so this is the graph for tan, right? This is the graph for tan. Now this is becoming discontinuous at this interval, that is at the pi by 2, it is discontinuous. At minus pi by 2, it is discontinuous. So if it is, this fx is coming out in this range, that is minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. So we'll say that the function is discontinuous at that particular point, right? So now, here we have, that is, this tan of fx. So tan of fx, so who will tell me tan of fx is continuous or not? So we'll try to take up the options one by one, A, B, C, or D. Yes, Ashish, Elvin, who would like to tell me where this tan of fx is continuous or not? So tan of fx is basically nothing but tan of x minus 2 by 2. This is tan of fx, right? So here, yes, Shubham. So whether this function is a tan of fx is continuous or not?
Yes, sir, it is continuous.
Okay, fine. So it is continuous, and because this x minus 2 is lying where?
It is continuous, sir.
Okay, fine. So where is this x minus 2 is lying? X minus 2 by 2.
Sir, it is lying between minus 1 to pi by 2 minus 1. And okay, in that domain, the tan of f of is not discontinuous, sir.
Yes, absolutely correct. So here we'll come to one more important part. That is what Shubham said is absolutely correct. So here, if you try to understand this, so this range, that is just x minus 2 by 2, right? So we know that this x is lying between where to where, 0 to pi, that's it. Now, we can subtract 2, so this is pi minus 2, and this is minus 2, and we can also divide by 2. So now we know that where this is lying. So minus 1 to x minus 2 by 2. And here we have pi by 2 minus 2. So now from this, it is very, very clear. This is not lying in the range where f, this tan of fx becomes discontinuous, because this is not lying between, because it is not reaching till pi by 2. Fine. So all of you agree with this, that we can say that tan of fx is continuous here? Yes, please raise your hands, because these are the only things that need to be discussed in this, tan of fx and about 1 by fx. Okay, good, very good. So now we have found out that this function is continuous, because this is nowhere, this complete x minus 2 by 2 is lying within this, right? It is not reaching this or this. Now, 1 by f of x. Now, 1 by f of x, all of you know that this is nothing but, if you try to say 1 by f of x. So 1 by f of x is clearly 2 by x minus 2, right? Now, this will be clearly discontinuous at x equals 2. And x equals 2 is lying between 0 to pi, right? So we'll say both, this is not continuous. So 1 by f of x is not continuous. Now, we have already shown that tan of f of x is continuous, but f inverse x. So who would like to tell me about this f inverse x? Now, only those people will raise their hands who will tell me about f of f inverse x. Okay. So now, let us try to hear from Elban. Yes, Elban.
F inverse of x is continuous, sir.
F inverse of x is continuous. Absolutely correct, because here you can find out by using y equal to x minus 2 by 2, you can find out x. That is coming out to be 2 also times pi plus 1.
Pi by 2 minus 1 there.
What?
In that tan thing, it's pi by 2 minus 1.
Okay, fine. So that is what, okay, fine. I got the point. The range you are talking about, x minus 2 by 2.
Yeah.
Okay, fine. So here, f inverse x is not continuous, it is written. So option B is not correct then.
And even in the answers, it's given option B is correct. I don't get
no,
it.
No. Option B is not correct at all. Right? So if it is given, all of you please try to correct that. Fine. So here, let us try to, let me try to again tell you this. That is, if you try to understand this important point, let us try to find out f inverse x if there is any confusion. You can have y equal to x minus 2 by 2. So first of all, Elban said this is, should be 1. That is absolutely correct. So from this, I am getting x is equal to 2 times y plus 2. Or from this, I am getting f inverse x is equal to 2 times x plus 1. This is everywhere continuous, right? So we don't need to worry about this. So f of x is not continuous is correct, incorrect. So if the answer is given to be B, so it should have been f of x is continuous, then the answer should have been B, right? So please make a correction in that, all of you.